Hey, I'm Gabrielle Shonk, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson here with Stingray PausePlay on the Juno Express in the Stingray Car with very special Canadian guest, Gabrielle Shonk.
Hello.
Hi. How are you? I'm stepping on your stuff. Welcome to the Stingray Car.
I'm doing amazing. How are you?
I can see you're doing amazing. Yeah. I'm also doing amazing. What is your happiest childhood musical memory?
My dad's a blues musician, so I remember I started singing with my dad, actually, and we would sing the song, I remember, the Lion Sleeps Tonight.
Oh, yeah.
So we would duet that song, exactly. And so that's like my, I think, oldest kind of performance, stage performance memory.
So which one of you did the, woo, like who went straight up?
My dad. Your dad did that, yep. He did the whole falsetto thing. He had it down.
And so your dad's a blues musician, but you never really got into the blues?
Not really, which is strange, I know. But I feel like it's in my roots, like it's in my whole background. My dad was very much into Motown and soul as well. Okay. So I feel like that's tinted my music more.
Yeah.
But I mean, I guess there's blues colors to it, but yeah.
And do you have a memory of the first time that you played an instrument? I'll assume it was probably with your dad, but
I think it was the piano, playing the instrument, a piano. I suck at piano, by the way. It's like, oh, she played with, no, I'm very bad. I play a bit of guitar now, but I think my parents got me into piano lessons when I was like in second grade. I wish I had continued.
I know.
I did.
I was violin, like violin for 4 years. And I quit.
What happened?
And I remind my parents how mad I am all the time. All the time. What brought on your first desire to kind of write a song? Because there's a big difference between picking up a guitar and playing at your friend's house at a party, but to write a song, like what was the reason that you first wrote your song?
There are kind of two stories to this, because I feel like there's two. I remember writing like a pop chorus, not on an instrument, just like a melody in my head when I was like 10.
Yeah.
I think it was like Dance Tonight or something like that, because I was in love. I listened to like the Backstreet Boys and Britney Spears and all that. I grew up in the 90s. Yeah. So there's that, which I remember very clearly for some reason. I was like, oh, this pop chorus, whatever. And then more seriously later on, I started playing guitar when I was in high school. And I was listening to a lot of acoustic, like emo bands. I opened for Dashboard Confessional last spring.
Okay, so this real, is kind of emo. Okay,
yeah, exactly. Okay. I was very much into Dashboard Confessional when I was like 15.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, oh, I want to do that whole thing solo singing. And so that's kind of what inspired me, I guess, to write. And so I started learning songs on guitar and basically kind of taking those chords and improvising over them.
Right.
So that's kind of how it happened.
Well, that's how it works.
Yeah,
that's kind of what songwriting is about. Yeah, you're doing it well. Yeah, you've done really well for yourself. We asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Hey, we're Moon versus Sun, and our question is?
Our question is, who is Mr. Brainwash?
okay.
I'll leave it to you.
This is not the answer, but to me, you know those books, like those children's books, the small kind of booklets, which is like Mr. Sunshine.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so you're picturing the Mr. Brainwash book.
But I know it's not that, but I have a goddaughter, and we had this theme where we gave her all one of those books. So I'm like, okay.
We all had those books. We
Mr. Brainwash.
Books.
I don't know
Mr.
what
Brainwash.
He does, but it's weird.
I'm going to find that book.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good. 2017 kind of brought us your self-titled album. There's a real vibe. It's sometimes Americana. It's sometimes R&B. There is some bluesy kind of vibes on the album. Which song was the hardest for you to complete?
I think the last one on the record, which is a French song. It's called Par Plus En Moi. And it was just a tricky song. I started writing it with my guitar player. Then we kind of rewrote it as a band. And it took like 10 million turns. I think at some point it was in, if I'm more technical, it was in 4/4. So it's and now it's like the 3/4 feel. All it
right.
ended
a
up
more
like
waltzy,
that, which,
I
yeah,
it, yeah,
exactly. More waltzy for, that makes sense to everyone. Yeah. But I think that's the one that was the hardest to finish. And it's funny because it ends the record. Anyways, things just happen like
that. It
just
happens that way. I know you're perfectly bilingual. And you write in English and in French. Will that be something you continue, you think, throughout your career to write in both?
Yeah, I've always been my first language is English, but I was raised in French and did all my school in French. But and since the music side comes from my dad, who's Anglo, I guess I've always been more prone to like write in English, I guess, because it's what I've been hearing forever. But so my first like response is kind of my first reaction is to write in English, I guess. But I do love singing in French, especially in Quebec, because people, people connect to the words and you have that kind of, it's just a different connection when people can really understand what you're saying.
100%.
So it's nice. So I want to keep that, definitely. But I know my kind of whole thing is a bit more Anglo, definitely.
Yeah,
but
okay.
Keeping that French in there.
Okay. You've got new music in the works.
Yeah.
Nothing that you can really discuss
or
share with me, and I will remind you of that for the rest
of
your life.
Yes, I'm sorry. I would love to.
So what can you tell me? What is coming up for you musically? When can people expect something from you, even a little tweet of a note?
Okay, that's a very good question, and I don't have an answer.
But are we will we hear new things in 2019?
Hopefully, yes.
Okay.
I would really love that. Yeah. I'm writing lyrics right now. I have music and melodies going on, but I'm working hard on that. So yes, definitely new music soon.
Okay, so if maybe we hear music, maybe we don't hear music. What is the goal for 2019? What would make 2019 a successful year for you?
Finishing this record.
Finishing the record.
Yes. Yeah. Making this record, or at least finishing the songs for this record.
And is it a similar vibe as what we've experienced before? Are you kind of going off a little bit of a different tangent?
It's a very new experience for me because the record, my first record, which is nominated, I wrote it. It's kind of the record of my life.
Yeah.
Like it's my first release and I'm 30. So it's like, well, what happened? But anyways, it's kind of my whole musical background is as this one is all new songs that have been written in this past year.
Yeah, right.
So that experience for me is completely different. It's really nice too, because I feel like there's a ligne directrice.
Yeah.
Direction, exactly. Yeah. It's more, a bit more, I guess it's clear, but very unclear. I'm exploring a lot of things, but I think it's like, it's my sound, but more mature.
Yeah.
Just naturally kind of evolving. Yeah.
You know, you're from Quebec, live in Quebec. Obviously, you know, we're based in Montreal. Montreal has given us some amazing artists, you know, Leonard Cohen, Arcade Fire, even Hubert Lenoir.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think it is about Montreal and Quebec that is so open and inviting to writers and performers and artists and composers?
That's a very good question. I think there's a lot of interest in, a lot of support and interest in musical culture, I guess. Like going out of Quebec and going out of Canada especially, I think the arts are very supported here compared to other countries. So I think that's very encouraging. I think there's, like more artists come out, the more other artists are kind of motivated and feed off of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know if there's like a real answer, but I feel like there's just a really good energy of everyone like kind of doing their stuff and pushing to go further with their music and just bring this outside of Quebec, the Quebec province, let's say.
Right.
And people have just been pushing towards that a lot and a lot more.
Yeah.
It's been just kind of opening doors for everyone, which is amazing.
Well, I'm so glad the door has been open for you because the album is so, so beautiful.
Thank you.
I can't wait for 2029 when I hear your next song that comes out. Stingray loves you. We play you all over. You can actually hear Gabrielle Shonk on Stinger Music's Adult Alternative Channel, Canadian Indie Channel, Top to Taunt Channel, and Franco Country Channels. And of course, don't forget to find the magnifying glass, the search icon on our web player and our mobile app. Type in Gabrielle Shonk to find the 12 channels that we play her music on. Thank you so much for hanging out with me.
Thank you.
We'll see you next time, guys.
Awesome.